Hi, this is Asghar Ghori. In this video, I'm going to show you some common uses of the popular Linux command called yum, which is available on Red Hat Enterprise Linux and its derivatives such as CentOS, Scientific Linux, Oracle Linux, and so on. I'm going to use my CentOS system called Server 1 for the demonstration portion of this video. Please note that I have already configured a yum repository on this system. For those of you who do not know what a yum repository is, in simple words, it is a kind of a digital library that is configured to store software packages for local or remote installation. If you wish to learn how to set up a yum repository, please see my YouTube video, How to Configure a Network Accessible Yum Repository. The yum command does not only operate on packages that are stored in repositories, it also works on packages that are located in any directory or folder on the system. However, its use is more common with repositories given a wealth of advantages that they provide. For more information on Linux, including exam preparation details for the RHCSA, RHCE, and CompTIA Linux Plus and LPIC1, see my latest publications as shown on this slide. These books are available at major online retail and app stores. The yum command is powerful and versatile. It is the front end to the RPM command. The primary advantage of using this tool is that it automatically selects and installs all the packages that are required by the software being installed. In other words, we can say that the yum command automatically satisfies dependencies for a successful installation of a software package. This command has a number of subcommands and options for flexible package management, and it works with individual packages that may be stored locally on a Linux system, as well as the packages that are located in remote yum repositories. I would like to provide an essential tip here for those who are in the process of preparing for a Linux certification exam. A solid working knowledge of the yum command is key to passing performance-based Linux certification exams based on Red Hat and its clones. These exams include Red Hat's RHCSA and RHCE, Linux Foundation's LFCSA and LFCE, and Linux Professional Institute's LPIC 3. At the same time, a good understanding of this command is important to score higher on Linux exams that are based on multiple choice questions. These exams include CompTIA Linux Plus and LPIC 1 and LPIC 2. We can use the yum command to execute a number of tasks on installed packages and on the packages that are available for installation but are not currently installed. Some of the basic package management tasks that we can perform with yum, and I will cover them in this video, are: number one, list installed and available packages; number two, install a package; number three, reinstall a package; number four, query installed and available packages; and number five, remove a package. Now let us run the yum command with some common subcommands to perform the management tasks that we have just highlighted. As mentioned before, I have already configured a repo on Server 1 and the repository is available for our use. Let's use the repo list subcommand with yum to confirm that. The output indicates that a repo with the repo ID 707repo is available, and it contains 3,538 packages in it. If you want to view details for the 707repo repository, add the -v option with the command. The output shows the repo ID, the name of the repository, the last update time, the number of packages it contains, the size of the repository information, the URL that can be used to access this repository from other systems on the network, the expiry time of the last update of the repo, and it is set to the default value of 21,600 seconds, which is equal to 6 hours, and the name and location of the configuration file for this repo. Let's start off with the list subcommand. To list all installed packages, we use yum list installed. The output reports the information about the installed packages in three columns. The first column shows the package name and the processor architecture it was created for. The second column displays the version of the package. And the third column identifies the repository from where the package was installed. Now replace the argument installed with available and rerun the command. The output now displays the list of packages that are available for installation from the repository that is identified in the third column. These packages are not currently installed on the system, but they are available for installation. We can also specify one or more package names to list their installation status. For instance, let's specify the package names gzip and ypserve with yumlist and see what it shows. The output shows that the package gzip is currently installed on the system, and it was installed at the time of OS installation. The @anaconda string right here in the third column indicates a repository that was used to install this package. The output also shows that the ypserve package is currently not installed. However, it is available for installation from the specified repository. If you're interested in viewing the list of all installed and available packages at the same time, simply run the yum command with the list subcommand and without any additional arguments. Here is an example, and I'll show the output one screenful at a time. List of installed packages here. Go further down. And here is a list of the available packages. Now let's look at installing and reinstalling software packages with the yum command. The subcommands available for these operations are called install and reinstall. The install subcommand requires that the specified package must not be already loaded on the system, and the reinstall subcommand requires that the specified package must already be loaded on the system, and it is going to override the current copy of the software package. Here is how we use them. Let's install a package called ypbind with yum install ypbind. Notice that the command has automatically selected another package called yp-tools to satisfy the dependency. The dependent package will be installed first, and then the actual package that we specified at the command line. Enter a Y here to confirm the installation. And as you can see, the packages have been installed successfully. At this point, if we try to install this package again, the command will report the existence of the package and that there is nothing to do about it, as you see on the screen. However, if we want to reinstall this package to override the installed version of it, we will use the reinstall subcommand. And in that case, we enter yum reinstall ypbind. And the dependency check and installation process will follow. The reinstall operation may be performed to override a corrupt copy of the package, or you are unable to install it, or some other issue with the installed package. Now that we have installed a package, let's use the info subcommand with the yum command to view the package information. So we enter yum info ypbind. YumInfo YP bind. And the output shows the name of the package. Right here, the name of the package, the architecture this package was designed for, the package version and release information, the size of the installed package, the install status of the package, the repo it was installed from, a summary information of the package, the URL where you can get more information about this software package, the license information, and a description of what this package is all about. The info subcommand treats an installed and an available package equally. It reads the package metadata for an installed package from the /var/lib/rpm directory, which is the package database and where information for installed packages is stored. And for the packages that are currently not installed on the system, it obtains the information from the repository metadata. For instance, to view information about a package called ZSH, which is not currently installed, we run the command yuminfo zsh. And the output shows the details for the package. And the yum command obtained this information from the metadata of the package, which is available from the repository. Next, let's look at the remove subcommand, which is used to remove one or more specified packages at the command line, as well as the packages that depend on them. The remove subcommand can also be invoked as erase. Both perform an identical function, just different names. Here is how we can erase the ypbind package. The yum command will automatically determine the dependent packages and it will include them in the removal process. The packages are identified and displayed on the screen, as you can see here, yptools, which is a dependent package, and ypbind, which we specified at the command line. Now enter a y to confirm the deletion of the packages. Now that you have learned the use of some of the common yum command operations, try the examples presented in this video on your own system to solidify the understanding. And this brings us to the conclusion of this video. If you like this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up, provide feedback, subscribe to channel Next Education, and share this video with your friends and colleagues. Thank you for watching. Bye now.